For comparison, we need minimum 2 years data or information. Whatever differences you got, you have to convert into percentage. Anything which is related to shareholders, we call it as shareholders fund. First one will be equity shareholders. The same question we have to subdivide into three. Asset we divide into two, fixed asset, current asset. Hello everyone, I am your Adarsh sir, lecturing Vidyashram PU College, the temple of excellence. Today we have taken topic called analysis of financial statement. What do you mean by analysis of financial statement? Each and everything we discussed in your previous session. Now, in this we have few tools. Which are the tools? Like comparative, common size and trend percentage. In today's session, we will discuss about comparative balance sheet. It is your 12 marks problem, compulsory in your examination. Comparative balance sheet. What do you mean by comparative? Comparative means comparison. For comparison, minimum we need 2 years information. For comparison, we need minimum 2 years data or information. Now, we have information or balance sheet of 2 years, 2016 and 2017. We are comparing 2017 with your 2016. Now, the following are the balance sheet of Alpha Limited as at March 31st, 2016 and 2017. They have given, you are required to prepare comparative balance sheet. You have to see this carefully. Why? Because in your examination, they may ask you comparative or else common size. Question will be same, but you have to concentrate this whether we are supposed to prepare comparative or common size. Now, how to do comparative balance sheet? Now, in this, we have equity and liability. In this, equity shares, reserve, long term, current liability. Now, in the assets, we have fixed assets, non-current, current asset, term loan and advances. These are the informations we have to calculate your comparative balance sheet. We'll go one by one. First, we'll complete your liabilities, then we'll come for your assets. Now, under liabilities, whatever given in the question, same thing we have to copy paste in your answer. Again, I repeat, whatever given in the question, same thing we have to copy in your answer. Then, after copying, we have to compare. I'll give you example. Your answer will be the same. In 2016, what was your share capital? It was 2 lakh. 2017, what is your share capital? It is 4 lakh. Comparing, if you compare with 2016, what is the difference? The difference is 2 lakh. The difference is 2 lakh. Similarly, it was 1 lakh, now it is 1 lakh 50. What is the difference? The difference is 50,000. It was 2 lakh, now it is 3 lakh. What is the difference? Difference is 1 lakh. Easy or very easy? It is very easy. Why? Because just you have to write as it is. Later, you have to find the differences. The differences you have to write. After writing differences, you have to convert this into percentage. Whatever differences you got, you have to convert into percentage. How to convert into percentage, we'll discuss. Now, in this, you have share capital. These are liabilities. Liabilities we have to divide into three. Again, I'll repeat. Your liability will be subdivided into three. Which are those? First one will be shareholders fund. Shareholders fund. This is your first one. Shareholders fund. Second one will be non-current liabilities. Non-current liabilities. This is your second one. And the third one is current liabilities. Current liabilities. So again, I'll repeat. Your liability are subdivided into three. Which are those? Shareholders one, non-current liability, and current liability. How to subdivide, how to classify in this? Shareholders fund. Anything which is related to shareholders, we call it as shareholders fund. Anything which is related to shareholders, we call it as shareholders fund. Now, in this, equity share capital, reserve and surplus, this comes under shareholders fund. I'll repeat. Your liability will be subdivided into how much? Three. First one will be shareholders fund, non-current liability, current liability. Under shareholders fund, which are the things will come? Write down one by one. Under shareholders fund, first thing will be your share capital. Share capital. Then reserve and surplus. Then profit and loss account. These three comes under shareholders fund. Understood? Yes. Now, under liability, we have three sub-classification. First classification will be shareholders fund. Under shareholders fund, what will come? Share capital, reserve and surplus, and P&L. Second classification, non-current liability. Non-current liability. Under this, debentures and long-term loans. These two comes under non-current liability. Now, under shareholders fund, these three. Under non-current liability, these two. What is the last subdivision? The last one is current liability. Under current liability, other than these things, everything will come. Other than these things, everything will come under current liability. Okay. Now, you will come to know how to classify equity share capital. Comes under what? Shareholders fund. Reserve and surplus comes under what? Shareholders fund. Long-term loan comes under non-current liability. Current liability comes under current liability. Simple. Yes, we'll go to answer. Now, equity and liability. Under this, what is the first one? Shareholders fund. What is the second one? Non-current. What is the last one? Current liability. The same question we have to subdivide into three. Under shareholders fund, we have equity, reserve, and surplus. Under non-current, we have taken long-term loan. Current liability, we can take directly. Now, how to write your answer? I'll go back to your question. Whatever amount they have given, everything copy-paste. We are doing up to this. Later, we'll do asset. We are doing up to liability. Later, we will do asset. Now, same amount they have taken, 2 lakh, 1 lakh 50, 2 + 3, 1 lakh 20, 1 lakh 70. From the question we copied. Now, increase or decrease in rupees, increase and decrease in percentage. Increase or decrease in rupees, increase or decrease in percentage. How to calculate? Simple. 2 lakh minus 4 lakh, answer is 2. 1 lakh minus 1 lakh 50, answer is 50,000. 2 minus 3, answer is 1 lakh. 1 lakh 20 minus 170, answer is 50. Up to this, any doubt? No. After this, the final column is your number we have to convert to percentage. How? Simple. What is your answer? I'll teach you this one. These things you only have to calculate. Now, your answer is how much? 2 lakh. We are converting to what? Percentage. Percentage means what? 100. Multiplied with 100, divided by, what is the first number? First number is 2 lakh. Divided by 2 lakh. Your answer, 100%. Clear? Yes. You have to take this answer, multiplied with 100, divided by first one. Why divided by first one means, first year is considered as base. On this basis only, we are doing this problem. Now, second one will do, you will understand. Now, what is your second one answer? 50,000. How to calculate? Same answer. 50,000. You are calculating what? Percentage. Percentage means what? 100. Multiplied with 100. Divided by. Go back to your first one. First one is how much? 1 lakh. So, divided by 1 lakh. If you cancel this, you will get 50%. How much? 50%. Similarly, calculate this. How to calculate? Simple. Take 1 lakh. Multiplied with what? Always 100. 100 divided by your first answer. 2 lakh. You will get 50%. Clear? This much only you have to do. Copy paste your question, calculate percentage. Now, your last one is how much? 50,000 multiplied with 100 divided by what? Your first answer, 1 lakh 20. Divided by 1 lakh 20,000, your answer 41.67. Like this, you have to calculate. At the end, it is 6 lakh 20,000, 10 lakh 20. What is the difference? Difference is how much? 4 lakh. Take 4 lakh. In this, 4 lakh multiplied with 100 divided by what? First answer, 6 lakh 20. 6 lakh 20,000. Your final answer, 64.52. Remember, you are not supposed to add your percentage. For the final answer also, you should calculate as it is we did for the previous one. Clear? Yeah. This is all about your liabilities. Liability, we have to divide into three. First one will be shareholders one. Second one, non-current liability. And third one, current liability. Under shareholders one, what will come? It will be share capital, reserve and surplus, profit and loss account. Second one, non-current liability. What will come? Long-term loan and debentures. Last one is what? Current liability. Under current liability, other than these things, everything will come. We'll go to asset. This is all about your liability. Now, asset. In asset, I'll go back to your question so that easy to understand. Now, these are the asset. Asset we divide only two. In liability, three. But in asset, we will divide only two. Which are those? First one, fixed asset and current asset. Asset we divide into two. Fixed asset, current asset. Now, fixed asset also we call it as non-current asset. Fixed asset also we call it as non-current asset. In this fixed asset they have given, non-current asset both are same, current asset different, term loan and advances comes under your fixed asset only. So again I'll repeat, in this fixed asset, this one and this one, we call it as fixed asset. Now current asset we have only one. This is separate. These three are separate. We'll go to answer. In the answer, we divided into two. One is fixed asset and the one is current asset. Now, fixed asset also we call it as what? Non-current asset. In this, we have fixed, non-current, term loan. These three comes under fixed assets. Now, whatever amount given, same thing, copy paste. Now we have to find out differences. Now 2 lakh minus 5, answer is 3. 1 lakh minus 125, answer is 25. 65 minus 70, the answer is 5. 255 minus 325, the answer is 70,000. Even your total also you should do. 620 minus 1020, your answer is how much? 4 lakh. Now, you got your answer. How to calculate percentage? Same procedure. Again, I'll repeat. Always remember, into 100, into 100, into 100, into 100. Into 100 is common. Now, divided by what? Divided by your first answer. 3 lakh multiplied with 100 divided by 2 lakh divided by 1 lakh divided by 65,000 divided by 2 lakh 55,000. So like this you have to calculate. Multiplied with 100 is common. Divided, always remember, you go back to your first column. The first column is we call it as base. So with the help of the base we have to divide, then you will get percentage. Clear? It should not be 100, it can be any number. Now last one, how to calculate? Simple. Multiplied with 100 divided by what? Yes, divided by 620,000. You will get 64.52. Like this you have to answer. This is all about your today's session. We did one problem on comparative statement. In this, which are the things you have to remember? You have to remember liability we subdivide into three. Assets we subdivide into two. Which are the subdivisions under liabilities? Yes, the first one is what? Shareholders fund. Second one, yes, second one will be your non-current liability. Third one will be current liability. Similarly, asset we divided into two. The first one will be your fixed asset and second one will be your current asset. Thank you.